Normally, I don't make videos about this kind of subject, but I was told to at the advice of a friend, so I'm just gonna do it. While I understand that I am not entitled to the support of my fans, I still kind of find it insulting that there are quote-unquote fans out there, I'm not gonna name names, that are willing to illegally download my music and share it on MediaFire. And here I am, barely able to support myself because my job is playing games with my schedule. I haven't been to work in over a week because they keep canceling the days that I'm supposed to work because of quote-unquote labor. Now, if your broke ass is not able to afford a $1 song and you don't have reliable internet to listen to my music for free on YouTube, then go ahead. I'm not gonna pursue you after that, but if you're sharing my music illegally, no, fuck you. I'm going to come after you. Because it's one thing to try and bypass the paywall I set up for yourself, it's another thing to try and bypass that paywall for other people. Because between my job strangulating my income and YouTube strangulating my income because they demonetized my channel again, fuck you, YouTube. And getting a new job in this market is a joke because of how extremely competitive it is. Oh, you have Asperger's syndrome? Guess who we're not hiring? There are people out there that have told me that I'm white and I shouldn't be able to complain about my financial issues because I'm white and privileged and all that garbage. Where was that white privilege when I was unemployed for 2.5 years? Where was that white privilege when I was fired from Little Caesars for being sick? Fuck you, Little Caesars. Where's that white privilege now that I'm struggling to support myself and assholes are stealing my music and sharing it illegally? Oh wait, that's right, it doesn't exist. And while I'm not entitled to my fans giving me money if they don't want to, I'm still entitled to my music being paid for. Because musicians and artists in general need to eat. Because if our job in real life is not cutting it, we need the sales of our music to be able to support ourselves. And that's kind of hard to do when people are pirating our music and taking money out of our wallets. Frankly, I'm just one man. I'm not some faceless corporation that you can just disassociate and not feel guilty about. And even if I was, it would still be wrong because that is nothing more than mental gymnastics to help you sleep at night. And for those of you who don't pirate my music, you know who you are. And you're all amazing people. Because even if you don't financially support me, you still respect my work enough that you don't steal my music. And that's appreciative enough. Make no mistake, I'm not lambasting my whole fan base because give me money. I'm just lambasting those few that don't respect my work enough to pay for the right to have it on their hard drive. Because I work hard and take pride in what I do when it comes to my music. There have been times where I haven't been able to make music for months, and I still went at it when I was able to. I've been making music ever since I was 16 and have kept at it for the last almost 10 years now. And so when I found out that this piece of shit was not only illegally downloading my music, but sharing it with other people, I had a rather strong emotional reaction. Now, mind you, I did not contact this person directly because one, fuck you, I don't want to talk to you, thief. And two, with my propensity to say offensive things like kill yourself, it was just a good decision overall just to not talk to this person. But I did get the DMCA hammer and banned this faggot's MediaFire repository of my paid music. In my next video, I'm going to be detailing ways on how you can support me whether you have money or not, because there are ways that you can support me at no cost to you. I'll be posting that in an hour or two, but until then, this is Revenge and I hope to hear from you soon.